Let us begin Bhagavad Gita, verse number 16 of 7th chapter. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Chaturvidha Bhajante Maam Jana Sukritin Arjuna Artho Jignyasur Artharthi Jnani Cha Bharat Arushabham. Bhagavan Krishna, having explained the Swarupa of his own nature, then he began to teach what is the cause of the problem. The problem is not understanding about Prakriti. That's what he called Maya Tattva. The entire world has got three gunas. So they are nothing but three guna aspects. These three gunas are nothing but Maya Karyam. In other words, we can also understand these five elemental aspects and this five elemental body. So between these two, we should not expect certain things. They are limited time-wise and space-wise. We are looking for something which they don't have. That is the problem. We believe these materials will bring happiness. There we commit mistake. That's what ignorance is. He gave in the 13th and the 14th verse the detail of the problem and mistakes. What is the real cause of the problem? The real cause of the problem is avidya, which is none other than maya, a force that which veils, that which projects in wrong way. That is the nature of Maya. In order to run the creation, Bhagavan has given it. If I understand my nature is beyond Maya Tattva and the Ishvara also beyond Maya Tattva. But in order to deal with Maya, we have to seek the help from Ishvara. That seeking help is known as bhakti. That bhakti is a transaction, as we saw in the yesterday's session. This bhakti, you know, there are four levels of bhaktis have been introduced in the verse number 16. We can say four varieties of bhaktas have been introduced, but there's four levels of bhakti. And we can divide into two categories, you know. There are two kinds of religious people: materially religious people, spiritually religious people. What is this materially religious people means? They use this devotion called bhakti in order to transact with the God. Okay, they have the transaction with the God. If I get the success, I will offer this much of money. If I become passed in the exam, I will offer this much of money. So if I get this much turnover or some kind of profit, I will do this. So this Kamya Prarthana are some people, when they are in danger situation, they want to come out of it, then they will have the prayer. This materially religious people is accepted, because every creature, they are born with longing. Not all people can be born like a Shuka Maharishi. Shuka Maharishi, when he was born, at that time itself, he was endowed with Purnatvam, completeness, adequacy. But other creatures are not like that. Especially human beings. So we have our own laggings. A cow, when it is born, a calf, it immediately could stand and walk. But human beings are not like that. But other animals, they need not to learn the language. But we should learn the language, that too, without a grammatical mistake. We have to communicate the things. We should look for the studies. We should get the certificate. We should get the job. We should own our family. We should take care of our family. And we have so many responsibilities as the captain of the ship, means as a family person. So all these things, you know, completely mess. So only I tell you, these desires will lead us. A bhakti means it's a, what I tell you, it's a glory. It's a fantastic things to happen in your life. If you are not able to establish bhakti, means according to me, that life cannot reach the destination, that life doesn't have the direction itself. You know, when you have the longing, longing means what? Desire. That longing means you have some inadequacy. So you have some incompleteness. So that that in order to get the completeness, you long for something. So a person who doesn't have a house, he will have the prayer to have the house. That person, if he goes to Tirupati, Tirumala, he will see Lord Venkateswara, who is in the form of house, or who provides the house. It means what? He looks at Venkateswara as a house. That's all. Some person will look at as the money. Some person look at as the success. So somebody else, they will look as like a power. Power means so to get so many powers, like a political power or power in a company. So he will get for promotion. So he looks at Venkateswara nothing but in the form of promotion. And you need not criticize this bhakti. This is also bhakti. It's a kind of transaction. Okay, this transaction also valid by our religious things. We call it materially religious people. It is acceptable. At the same time, so one more person who is little bit grown enough. So when he wants to get something, Venkateswara provides something, so he has the attitude, so everything is because of Venkateswara. So he becomes the, slowly he converts himself into spiritually religious person. That spiritually religious person means he could see that all objects which are provided by Venkateswara, they are nothing but prasadas. Prasada means a gift from Bhagavan. And Bhagavan also gives whatever we want to get. At the same time, he also sends little bit maturity, clarity, and not only that, complete viveka and vairagya. Slowly the person will develop vairagya. Vairagya means what? A clarity. So this materialic world, these materials don't have what I need. He will come to a conclusion. From that conclusion, he will start thinking, so what else should I ask? He will get the confusion. I asked for a house, he gave, but I didn't get satisfaction. Then I asked for money and job, he gave, then no satisfaction achieved. Then I asked for good family, so good wife, good children, so everybody is good at character, but I am not satisfied. So I wanted to have a good position in the society, I got it, but not satisfaction took place. Then what else I need? What else I could ask? Whatever that I thought I could get satisfaction through, I asked, everything Venkateswara provided, but that satisfaction is not able to achieved. Then somebody will tell, you should ask him itself. What should I ask him itself means what? You should ask him itself. You should warn him. Warn him means what? So you ask him to be always with you. Then what? You will be satisfied. Wow. So whatever I asked, he gave. If I ask him, so he should be with me always, then definitely he will do it, isn't it? Bhakti is gives the energy to own Ishvara himself. That bhakti is known as Jignyasu Bhakti. I need God himself. And he should not demote other devotees. He should not feel or he should not see in a perception, so all other people are inferior than him. This Jignasu Bhakti has got some clarity. Now he knows what to be asked. Now he has the conclusion, Acha, these worldly materials, they cannot give what I need. I need complete satisfaction. I need complete security. Only Ishvara, if he is existing with me, then alone it is possible. I'll ask Ishvara itself. Then he goes to the temple. He started asking himself. Then the Guru will let him know how you can own the Ishvara. By identifying him in you, you can own Ishvara. Once you identify you are none other than his Swarupa, then Ishvara is identified, means owned. Apna liya. Okay? Then once he receives this knowledge, then he is converted himself into Jnani Bhakta. He doesn't have the difference between Venkateswara and him. He doesn't have the difference between world and him. Everything is one. That bhakti is known as Eka Bhakti. Eka Bhakti means it is known as Advaita Bhakti. That bhakti is known as Jnani Bhakti. Now you have to remember one thing. When I began to explain, there are three levels of Ishvara's realization. The first level, accepting God as the creator, isn't it? Then the second level, so understanding God alone has become the world. Now first level understanding, we can see the Artha Bhakti and Arthati Bhakti. Okay? And this Jignasu becomes the world alone God, the third level understanding. Means the second level understanding. So first two level bhaktis belong to first level understanding of Ishvara. Then second level understanding comes third level of bhakti. So that bhakti, he could realize the world itself created by Ishvara, but Ishvara alone is the shelter for me, not the apara prakriti. So he is very clear about it. So I need to get para prakriti. That is third level, means third level bhakti called Jignasu Bhakti. Then finally he gets the mission accomplished. He becomes one with the God. That is third level understanding of Ishvara. So that is Vivarta Upadana Karana Ishvara. So there is only God. That's, I am also nothing but God. Everything is nothing but God. So Venkateswara and me, one and the same. Now you see, now Venkateswara could see as his own Swarupa. He got Ishvara. Now when he got Ishvara, he becomes Ishvara. But he never say, I have become Ishvara. He will politely say, so there is Ishvara. Everything is Ishvara. That's politeness, humility. So he will develop the humility. So everything what happens, they are not away from Ishvara. For him, positive energy, negative energy, is nothing but Ishvara. This Jnani Bhakti, so tragedy and good incidents, auspicious thing, inauspicious things, both are Ishvara. Beautiful things, ugly things, Ishvara. A Jnani Bhakti can see so positive and negative aspects of the creation, they are nothing but Ishvara. Bhagavan Krishna himself will reveal the secret in the 11th chapter. There we will learn. So the world has got positive side and negative side. The negative is not negative. Positive is not positive. So both together is called Ishvara. The Jnani Bhakti, so for him, the world is nothing but only Ishvara. For him, there is no creation at all. Therefore, he is Priyaha. The 17th verse, let us read it. Tesham Jnani Nitya Yuktaha Yeka Bhaktir Visheshyate Priyo Hi Jnani Notyartham Aham Sachamam Apriyaha. These two verses we have already seen the meaning, but now we are digging more elaborately, then these two verses can be digested well. Now once you own the Ishvara, you could identify Ishvara, so with your own real self, then what will happen? So you can see only Ishvara, that's what he says. So he becomes lovable to me, I becomes so lovable to him. And aham cha sacha mama priyaha. So both nature becomes one. Therefore what? Both become near, dear people. Ishvara and Bhakta become one. That's all. Therefore, I love Jnani because Jnani, he is not separate than me. Now you know Ajnani who separates me from him. That's what conclusion, that's what the teaching of Bhagavan Krishna. I never separate the people from me, they separate from me. That's what he spoken in the verse number 17, I think. So the people who are deluded by Maya, they keep me away. This is because of their papa phala. Next words, udara sarvaye vaite jnani tvatmaiva mematam asthitasahi yuktatma mame vanuttam angatim. Sarve ete udaraha. All these devotees are respectful people. All of them are great people. But Jnani, he could find, means he could identify my nature as his nature. Therefore what? So according to me or according to him, so myself is his self. In the same way, I also feel his Swarupa and my Swarupa, one and the same. Asthitaha sahi yuktatma mameva anuttamam gatim. He alone, the person who is endowed with the proper track. He alone, the person who achieved what to be achieved. He alone, the person who is the great pioneer in this life. That's what now this Jnani becomes very rare in our society. This person is called Asthitaha. And what is that? He alone established one. So this Arudham Pravartaha sa Jnani hi esmad ahameva. He alone established, well established one. In the next words, he gives more importance to Jnani. Bahu nam janma nam ante jnanavan mam prapadyate vasudeva sarvamiti samahatma sudurlabha. He is very rare. Samahatma, that great soul, so he is very rare to see because he has the understanding Vasudevaha idam sarvam. So he has thing, God alone is everything. Isha vasyam midag sarvam. The same understanding, Upanishadic understanding, in which his mind is being absorbed. Bahunam janpanam anthe. So not in one janma. So it's, you know, he might have began from before so many janmas. Now he reached, and it is very rare difficult to see like that jnani, and people also are gifted when they have jnani like him. That's what etan bahunam janmanam ante jnanavan mam prapadyate. So after achieving so many janmas, he reaches me. Next words, kamaistaistairhrutajnanah prapadyantenyadevatah tam tam niyamamasthaya prakrutyaniyatasvaya. Now Bhagavan Krishna, he gives a little bit more detail about the desire. Because everything is because of our desire. There are two kinds of lifestyle. You can begin the life by fixing the destination. Once you fix the destination, you could select the desire. Okay? In another way, you can select the desire, so the desire will get to the destination. Because human being, so they don't have the capacity to select the destination. Therefore, scriptures, they give your destination is moksha, your destination is moksha, your destination is moksha. Keep repeating it, but we don't bother. Nobody bothered about moksha. Who need moksha, Swamiji? I need to have 10 crore rupees. That will be, you know, kamme aayega. Panik aitindi. Velaki aagodu. So this moksha, you know, I don't need. I may need after 90 years. When I cross 90, then at that time I will work for moksha. What will you do? That's what, you know, whether we accept or not. The Upanishads and Shastra, it hits directly first, you know, in the Bhajagovindam. The Acharya says, in the beginning itself, Samprapte sannihite kale nahi nahi rakshati dukrunjkarane Bhajagovindam, Bhajagovindam, Govindam Bhajamudhamate. We don't know when death takes place. So everybody should have a longevity, that's my prayer. But the reality is, we don't know which is the last breath. He says, you know, don't dig with these karmas and this kid level's desires. You fix the ultimate desire, that ultimate to be sought. Then you are considered great soul. Now selecting desire is the main phenomenon in one's life. Because when you select the desire, not knowing the destination, then you cannot have proper, you know, travel. Or select the desires, the desire which was prescribed by our great people. Now, for example, one person has always desiring to see new places, new people, new food, new language, new colors of attiring dress. He wants to see and experience varieties of people and varieties of food, varieties of places. Okay, he can be given a proper target. Therefore, we have 108 Vaishnava sthalas. There are 118 places of which are told in the Vaishnava Sampradaya. And there are 51 places, 51 pithas of Shakti, Shakti Pitha. And there are innumerable Shivalayas. So those can be given as the destination. Small destination. Every week, so one city, one devata, another week, another month. So the lifetime is not enough to complete them. But those desire will connect him with the proper destination called moksha, whether he understand or not. when he traveled to Badri, Kedar, Haridwar, Kedar, Rishikesh, or Vrindavan, Kashi, so Rameshwaram, so all these places, they automatically connect you with the ultimate goal. This is what the life has to be. But here, he says, Kamaihi Taihi, Taihi Kamaihi Kritajnanaha Anya Devataha Prapadyanti. The bhakti has got a kind of deficiency. Bhakti doesn't have any deficiency within it. But bhaktas, if they are not having proper shraddha, then the density of the bhakti becomes less. Having different desires, the desires which are governed by adharma, adharmic desire. You know, Bhagiratha had the devotion to bring what? Ganges to the earth. But Ravana also had the bhakti. He plucked one head and one hand. He made a veena or tampura and he played samagana. And he was also provided boon by Lord Shiva. And there are so many varieties of devatas have been introduced. Even nowadays, there is Smasana Kali. So all people are going to the graveyard to worship. Innumerable bhakti worships. So these worships, will they take to proper destination or not? That's what Krishna wants to give the clarity. First, he said there are four levels of bhaktis, and also he said three levels of understanding of the Ishvara, and these are all like we call it a great path, Raja Marga, Chakkani Raja Marga. So you understand in English, this is very difficult to this is the route for the palace. Yeah, it's the main route for the palace, which is known as moksha. But there are so many other routes also, paths also. So they consider that also useful. But Bhagavan Krishna gives more clarity, whatever the way, in whatever the form you worship, that worship is valid, but your desire must be governed by dharma. You should not desire which is against dharma. That bhakti won't give what you need. Because bhakti will always should give dharmic fruit. But if you misuse it, then problem is not for the deities. You cannot blame the worship method, but you become the person who can be blamed. Therefore, in those branches of the bhakti also will be discussed by Lord Krishna, and he gives a proper clarity. And he will talk about why I am talking about this kind of, Anya Devata Bhakti. That we will see from next episode tomorrow. Harihi Om.